Welcome back to another 5-minute devotional. Today we're going to be talking about prayer, something I feel like that at times in my life is something that I put on the back burner or is something that I become weak in, and that is my prayer life. And so I want to title today Purposeful Prayer, because I believe at times we can view prayer as just something on our list throughout our day that we check off and we move on from it. And so we're going to dive into Thessalonians and see what that has to say about it. But today we're going to be talking about purposeful prayer. Well, like I said, we're going to be in 1 Thessalonians, and we're going to read chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. And so I'm going to read that first, because I believe it just sets up this devotional really well. It says, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this will of God in Christ Jesus for you." And so I'm just going to make a couple points, and the first one is pray without ceasing. Something that I feel like that I don't do on a regular basis is pray in every moment. Pray when I'm in a high, pray when I'm in a low, pray when I'm, you know, on my way to something that's stressing me out, pray within the stress, pray after the stress, because I believe within that, when we pray all the time, then the things I'm gonna list here at the end will work. Because some of you may say, "Ben, how do I, you know, pray to God when I'm thankful? How do I pray to God when I'm in pain? How do I ask? How do I listen?" That's a lot of prayer, when really if we look about our day and say, "God, I'm not just going to make prayer a time that I pray over my food or pray that you give me strength throughout the day and then I don't pray to him until the next morning." But we truly pray in all circumstances. It could be on your way to work. It could be before a meeting. It could be during a meeting. It could be just as you're walking the halls to wherever you're going, in your car, whatever it may be. It doesn't have to be a moment where you sit for 10 minutes completely eyes closed and bow down to him. And yes, that is fantastic and we need those times. But for some of us, don't overlook just that short 10 to 30-second prayer, walking into a meeting, "God, give me the words to say. God, give me the strength I need. Thank you, Jesus, for today." Whatever it may be. And so I want to talk about that. So first, you need to pray without ceasing. Something I feel like that I need to do, and I'm going to put it on my list that I need to do more of. And the reason we need to do that is because we live with a relationship with Jesus Christ. And if you don't, I would challenge you to get connected with somebody in a local church, figure out, you know, what does this mean? What does a relationship with Jesus Christ mean? And that's for another devotional. But when you decided that you were following after him, you decided that you wanted a relationship with him. And a good relationship has clear and precise communication. And so with that, communication needs listening and talking. And so first, talk to him. Ask for the things that are on your heart. Ask for the needs and the desires and the wants that you feel. He may start to change your desires and start to, you know, move different things up your priority list, but that's what this relationship does. That's what prayer does. Secondly, listen. I'm someone who, it's really hard for me to listen to learn or listen to understand instead of listening to respond. I do it quite often, and so I want to challenge you to not listen to respond, but listen to learn. Maybe you've been talking so much you can't hear his voice. We've talked about that before. Or maybe you're someone who is just sitting here listening, but he just wants you to start the conversation, so maybe you need to ask. And then lastly, thank him. Thank him for the things he's given you. Thank him for the breath to breathe, the life to live, you know, a new day, whatever it may be. Thank him, because it's when you kind of have all of those things happening in one, you'll see your prayer life becomes easy. It becomes just fluid. It happens every day. You don't even notice it, but you're sitting at your desk, you're in your car, at your job, with your family. You're just thanking him. You're talking to him. You're rejoicing in him. You're confiding in him. You're confessing things to him. And it doesn't become something so scary, but it just becomes something that is part of your relationship, because that is what a good relationship has, and that is communication. And so I hope this spoke to you. I want to read the scripture just one more time as we close, because it says, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing." That's my prayer for you today, is that you will do that, and then you will give thanks in all circumstances. So I hope you enjoyed this devotional. I challenge you to stop right now and pray. And that's what I'm going to do now, is I'm going to pray over you guys as we close and just thank God for this time. Dear Lord, I just thank you for this moment. I thank you for this day. I thank you for whoever this devotion will come in contact with, God. I pray you would just use it, speak to them, continue to speak to me. And again, God, like we said, God, we thank you for your breath to breathe, the life to live. And we thank you for your son paying the highest price. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.